Right, that's right. I mean, we had decided to close a short on Monday, in part because we felt that the valuation already was reflecting all the risks in the business. You had gone from a stock that traded in the low mid-20s to mid-teens, almost in line with Anheuser-Busch. The drop of about $70 in the share price since October was more than reflected in terms of the drop in the Canopy growth investment, as well as the market downdraft. The scanner data into the quarter had looked pretty decent, so we and other people had become more constructive into the print, and we wanted to be neutral in front of the numbers. So what we missed, and what happened today, is that the guidance for the fourth quarter was set about 20% below consensus. There are some questions about the underlying growth in the beer business. Instead of, you know, you're running there at high single digits, which is much better than the rest of the industry, but there are some concerns that a lot of the growth is coming from extensions like Corona Premier, Corona Familiar, and that your core business could be diluted and slowing and actually falling. And at the same time, you know, there's this big cash flow question. This is a company that's already invested $4 billion in Canopy growth, may have to invest another $5 billion over the next, you know, call it 2 years and a half, and they generate about $1.3 billion in free cash flow every year. So I think what the share price is telling you today is that there are risks in the underlying beer business, questions about EPS growth in fiscal year 20 and in February, and all this in the context of a balance sheet that could be constrained. You're almost at 4.5 times net debt to EBITDA.
What happened with wine and spirits?
Yeah, what they have, the issue there is that wines and spirits is a business that about 30%, they want to follow the premiumization trend in beer and in wines and spirits. But their business in wines and spirits is it's only 30% in terms of volumes above $11. So they have a big tail that they have to fix, and that's an issue. Demand for lower-priced wines, it's not strong, it's declining, and they are suffering because of that. You have operating leverage issues there. You have business issues there. But if I step back, I think that, you know, this is a stock that's been, for the most part, beloved by the hedge fund community. They've done very well. Robert Sands, you know, had stepping down as CEO. He's generated almost 800% return for shareholders over the years. So it's a stock that it's a great story in growth within consumer staples, historically it's been, and a great cash flow story because most of the cash was free cash flow was being returned to shareholders in dividend and buybacks, and they maintain a very efficient balance sheet. The problem is that the growth story right now could be broken. That's what the stock is telling you in terms of a question mark. And you have all this big commitment with Canopy growth in terms of future investment.
So you made clear in your note on Monday, Pablo, that it was a balance sheet risk story going into this year and perhaps the following year. With the declining growth story or the growth story in question and potentially higher interest rates, how exposed is Constellation in terms of its debt payments? And should we be concerned about the balance sheet?
Right. I mean, what the company... To be clear there, with the company sounded pretty upbeat in terms of their balance sheet and cash flow going forward. They talked around, you know, that they want to be able to return $4.5 billion to shareholders over the next 3 years, that they will also be able to exercise the warrants in the case of Canopy growth. So it seems that it's all in pretty good shape. I don't entirely agree with what they said because, again, they have a 4.5 times net debt to EBITDA balance sheet. The free cash flow per year is about $1.2 billion. And if they exercise the warrants outstanding on Canopy over the next by end of November 21, that's another $5 billion you have to invest. So, you know, could there be a risk of a rights issue at some point that Constellation has to do? So just to wrap up, you know, you have a core beer business that's great relative to the rest of the industry, mm-hmm. but seems to be slowing, particularly for the core brands. And then you have a company that in 2 years' time could have invested almost $9-10 billion in cannabis. When your market cap, it's $30 billion, right?
Wow.
So yes, there are questions, there's potential growth in that industry, no doubt, but there is a balance sheet risk.